Let's imagine that we want to design a PCB. On one side, we pull the supply line, and on the opposite side, the ground line. In between, we want to place two circuits, a digital circuit and an analog circuit. Let's just draw the traces as shown here. What do you think? Is this a good design? If not, why not? The answer is, it depends. But in most cases, it's just a bad design. EMC-aware PCB design is very important. The general problem is that traces are not ideal with 0 ohms resistance. On the contrary, every single trace has an impedance to consider, no matter how short it is. The ohmic part is determined by the dimensions of the trace and the materials used. Let's just say 10 milliohms for a 1 cm trace length. The real troublemaker, however, is the inductive part, which is represented here as 10 nanohenry inductance. Let's assume that the digital circuit performs fast switching operations. Let's say that 10 milliamps flow for a very short time but in periodic intervals. This causes a peak voltage drop of 0.1 millivolt across our parasitic resistor. That is not a big deal. However, at the inductor there is a voltage drop of 100 millivolts. We cannot neglect that because the question you have to ask yourself is, does our analog circuit still have a good ground potential? The answer is no, because this potential is regularly raised by 100 millivolts. We thus have galvanic coupling between both circuits via this common impedance. A noise signal can therefore couple from one circuit into the other circuit. Ultimately, we have to think every single trace in its equivalent circuit to find more common impedance paths. Consequently, we can say that this is just a bad layout.